बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज़ मिस अनम, माइक्रोबायोलॉजिस्ट एंड एम्फिल स्कॉलर। एंड टुडे माय टॉपिक इज टिश्यू कल्चर टेक्निक्स। सो लेट्स जस्ट स्टार्ट अवर टुडेज टॉपिक। बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग माय टुडेज टॉपिक, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल, प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल and like and also share with your friends. First of all, I gonna explain the history about the tissue culture techniques. History: in 1885, William Rocks maintained chicken embryonic tissues in warm saline for days, establishing the principle of cell culture. Ross G. Harrison published his work from 1907 to 1910, establishing the method, the methodology of tissue culture. Then afterwards, in 1940s and early 1950s, cell culture techniques were advanced significantly, in part to support research in virology. The injectable polio vaccine developed by Jonas Salk was one of the first product mass produced using cell culture techniques. Viral cultivation. Basically, for which purpose cell culture is used? Is used for viral cultivation mostly. I am explaining it further in the written context. As bacteria, virus cannot be cultured independently. They require inoculation in certain cell cultures, host animals, or embryonated eggs. Medium required for cultivation of virus consists of a mixture of nutrients, vitamins, ions, antibiotics, and certain growth factors. Techniques used for the viral cultivation: cell and tissue culture, embryonated egg, premature form, live animal. These are the pictorial view of techniques used for the viral cultivation. In the first picture, is shown that live animal is being used for the viral cultivation. Now it's banned in few areas or few countries. Then live embryonated chick egg is used, and other one is cell culture or the primary or secondary cell line is being used for the viral cultivation. Tissue culture, cell culture technique. The term tissue culture is interchangeably used with the term cell culture. Tissue culture is the process or technique of making selective tissue cells grow in a culture medium outside the organism under controlled conditions. This technique most commonly used for the viral cultivation. The primary purpose of viral cultivation are to isolate and identify virus in a clinical specimens, to prepare viruses for vaccines. These are the main points for the viral cultivation: to do detailed research on viral structure, multiplication cycles, genetics, and effects on host cells. Now coming to the next slide, basically three types of cell culture techniques are Wien study. These are the three types of cell culture being used for the viral cultivation. One is explant culture, second one is organ slice, and third one is cell line. These three cultures, I will further explain it in the next slide. Why these cultures are being used? For the optimization of cell culture, selection of assay for toxicity evaluation, development of biomarkers for in vitro toxicity evaluation, dose response relationship, data interpretation, validation of in vitro test methods. Now coming to the next slide, there are three types of cell culture techniques. One is organ culture, second one is explant culture, and third one is cell line culture. Now I am explaining all three cultures one by one. First one is the organ culture, in which small bites of organ from human or animal is maintained in a tissue culture media are mainly done for the highly specialized parasites of certain organs, example tracheal ring culture for the isolation of coronavirus. Explant culture is a technique to organotypically culture cells from the pieces of tissue or organ removed from a plant or animal. This technique is rarely used. Now the third one, cell line culture. A cell culture is the culture developed from a single cell and therefore consisting of cells with a uniform genetic makeup. Cell line culture is routinely used in lab for virus culture isolation identification. Cell culture media are complex mixtures of salts, carbohydrates, vitamins, amino acids, metabolic precursors, growth factors, hormones and trace elements, some antibiotics and serum, etc. The requirement of these components vary among cell line. Why these requirements are important? Because to limit the growth of other organisms like bacteria or fungi. Procedure for cell line culture: tissue fragments after washed and treated with trypsin, collagenase and EDTA are centrifuged in a washing medium. Washed cells are incubated in a suitable growth medium at 36 centigrade for 72 hours. Once the cells form monolayer, the virus are inoculated on it. As a result, localized areas of cellular destruction and lyse of cell called plugs are formed. This method can be varied accordingly. There are three types of cell line culture: primary cell line culture, semi-continuous diploid cell line culture, or the continuous cell line culture. Types of cell line culture. In this picture, I explained the few types of cell line culture: the primary cell culture, then the secondary cell culture, then the continuous cell line culture. Coming to the next slide, primary cell line are normal tissue cells, animal or human derived, that grow only for few generations in vitro. They are used for primary isolation of viruses and production of vaccine. Example, monkey kidney cell culture, human amnion cell culture, etc. Semi-continuous diploid cell line culture. They are diploid cells having same number of chromosomes as their parent cells. There is a rapid cell division and after 50 serial subdivisions, they undergo senescence. The diploid cells are susceptible for a wide range of human virus culture and vaccine production. Example, rhesus embryo cell, human embryonic lung strain, etc. Now the continuous cell line. These are usually cancer cells, haploid cells derived from cancerous tissues, capable of infinite growth in vitro. They are termed as continuous cell line as they serially subculture for indefinite generation without growing sentience and can be stored as 70-70 degree centigrade. Not used for vaccine production. Example: HeLa, cervical cancer cell, BHK21 baby hamster kidney cell line. And these are the few pictorial view of the examples. Now these are the list of method used for virus quantification, so that how you may quantify the virus using a PCR, quantitative PCR, viral plug assay, ELISA, hemagglutination assay. These are the few most important methods of viral quantification. I hope my video would be very helpful for you. So please subscribe my channel. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Thank you.